so it's Sunday morning. A certain candy lady who's got the same initials as a white wrapper wanted to know about how to make grits. I'm going to start with 2 cups of that in that pot and about 3/4 of a cup of grits. These may end up being the best grits in the history of the world. We're gonna find out. And then you stir it and put it in a bowl with bacon. See, and then you got bacon and French fries with your grits. And then people want to see you eat it, right? So hold on. And then you eat it. Grits, a French fry, and bacon. Oh my God. Anything to, I'm not going to put you on camera at 6:09 on Sunday morning, but anything to say? Just rubbing her stomach. So imagine that, it's raining on a Sunday. God forbid they wait till 10:30 or 11 o'clock in the morning on a rainy day to get fed. Jesus Christ, man. And I know hunger don't stop, but sometimes this one right here, super vocal. There you go. Have some fresh straw. You know, it's funny. I come outside and I have to make a decision which one of these trucks I'm going to drive. And like I need to wash this truck, but every time I wash this truck, it fucking breaks down, and I'm afraid to wash it. Like, it's running good, but it's parked next to a puddle. But like, I got that big old thing over there that makes fucking vroom vroom noises, but like, I'm so partial to this truck. I've had it for so many years that it's hard to discount this truck, but like, it's parked over here next to a puddle, and it's fucking filthy. But if I wash it, it'll break down. Oh, I did the big dirty. Every time I wash it, it breaks down, so we'll see. I took her to the old car wash and washed her up. We'll see. As long as it makes it home, that's all that matters. I'm out of breath. And it's not without cause. I just walked up that hillside. Whew. That's a fucking challenge. You want to talk about some fucking spiders. But I walked up that hillside to show you. I also, Jesus, can't even speak. I'm just out of breath. I also own all of this. Like, that's mine. That's mine. That's kind of braggable. Sort of. It's a long fucking walk up the side of that hill, though. Fuck. Now, I'm not going to say that these two cats are friends. The wife just filled up the food bowl. And the big girl is being patient, understanding that the little guy is not going to eat all of it. It's about the most progress I think we've made. They both actually slept on our bed at the same time last night. Even though I feel like when Bitch Kitty sleeps on my bed, I need to bleach my skin because she's so gross. She's been living out in the trees in the mud.
Bad choice.
Yeah. Haven't been letting her in much because she's gross. Like, and if you start bringing yourself back around and clean yourself up, we might let you in a little more. But they are patient and tolerant of one another. He likes to chase her. She swats him in the face a little bit. Got a couple of good kitties. Welcome. Back to my little piece of paradise here. You can see it's a rainy day. About 65. I'll give a little bit of context as to why this week's video is turning up being this. And if you don't care about what I've got to say and you just want to see what I'm doing out here, when I'm actually doing it, that's cool. Skip off this video, because from here to the end of this is going to be me talking about what's going on in the world right now and what's going on in my world in relation to what's going on in the world around me. I don't watch news. I have a select few places that I trust to report the truth, that I read things from. But if it's anything to do with a network news, somebody on a YouTube channel trying to report news, okay, I don't buy it. There's literally like three places. And I'm not even going to get into those, because then that becomes a political debate. Supply chain delay, whatever you want to call it. Bunch of boats sitting on both sides of the country, not being able to be unloaded for whatever reason. Whether it be because the crews are not vaccinated, or that nobody wants to work. To which, I don't know if anybody's ever been to the Port of Los Angeles. I've been to the Port of Los Angeles, and I find it highly unlikely. Number one, those are all union jobs. So I find it highly unlikely that any of those people, unless they were standing around picketing, are not working, because they show up and they do their union jobs for however much they get paid. And I've got opinions about union workers, having been a non-union worker working with union workers. But let's just say that the Port of Los Angeles, that place runs 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. And there is never any shortage of container trucks running up and down Interstate 5, Interstate 10, Interstate 8, going where they need to go, or on the backs of trains going across the country. Same thing could be said about the Port of Charleston on the East Coast. I've been into that, and the Port of Charleston, there's constantly container ships coming and going and coming and going and coming and going, and I cannot possibly see any scenario where the people who own those ports are literally not unloading the boats. So I don't understand what's happening there. Far right wants to blame Joe Biden. Far left wanted to blame President Trump for everything that he did, when the sooner you figure out what's going on with politics, we could have elected a grilled cheese sandwich for president, and he probably would have been better. People would probably be laughing at us less for either of our last presidential selections. I had nothing against Donald Trump, and I don't particularly have anything against Joe Biden, other than the man can't put together three sentences in a row off of a teleprompter without smelling some child's hair. But anyway, we literally could have elected a grilled cheese sandwich with a face on it, and it would have been as functional in what's happening with the government. It's what's going on in the House, the Senate, anyway, we're not getting too far into politics here. You got to blame the people who are under him. He's just a talking head. I don't think the man even has the mental capacity to even, I don't know. They hand him a piece of paper, he signs it. It's whatever they're doing in Congress, whatever they're doing in the House. And I'm trying not to follow it, but where I'm getting at with this, I have not filmed hardly anything here at the house this week because I'm starting to realize that there's a tiny little grocery store here in town and a Dollar General, okay, that are in this little town. There ain't nothing in them. There's no toilet paper. There's no water. There's no fresh chicken. There's no fresh vegetables. There's no frozen chicken. There's no freezer pizzas. What I'm able to find locally here in this town, quite literally, is very, very, very limited. I found like a generic 12-pack of soda because for whatever reason, Pepsi isn't delivering. I should ask my brother about that. He's a Pepsi delivery guy. But he's on the other side of the country and he would have no idea about the logistics of over here because he's in Northern California where I grew up. I was literally only able to go and find like $14 worth of stuff at the local grocery store. So I've been on the road. Forgive me for being paranoid. As you can tell, the seasons are changing behind me. The leaves are starting to fall. I don't think it's going to be a very colorful season. Everything is just turning brown and falling. So we'll see how that goes. Yesterday, I went with my mother. We drove 2 hours up into Kentucky to make a run. And there were places that we stopped that we didn't even buy anything because they didn't have anything. So we stopped, and I mean, it's literally taken me a trip to three different Walmarts in the last week, and I hate Walmart. I would rather spend money in the community, but when the community doesn't have anything to buy, sadly, your option is Walmart. But you get to Walmart, okay, and there ain't nothing in Walmart either. The shelves are empty, and there produce is, and it's like a fucking chaos. I found another grocery store when we were in Kentucky yesterday where I was able to get some things. But this is like when I lived in Charleston and there was a hurricane blowing in and you go in there and there's no bread, there's no water, there's no milk. There's literally nothing in the stores. And that has me worried. So I have been, I started noticing this on, been reading about it. I don't make it to the store very often because I buy in bulk because it takes me an hour to get there. We started realizing this, my wife and I, on Saturday. We went to a car show on Saturday morning, which I haven't decided whether that's going to be part of this video or not. I took a little bit of footage there. I might just group it all together so that there's 20 minutes of whatnot to watch this week. As you'll see there, we also stopped at the livestock auction. That was kind of a cool place, but we don't have any. I wasn't there for livestock. I was just there to look. However, it might get to the point where I have to buy my own cow. And if that's the case, I was just trying to be familiar with the establishment, the facility, and take a look at what people were wearing in there so that I don't show up looking like a complete clown in a brand new pair of boots, to which I'll show up looking like a clown in brand new boots once, and I'll come back in dirty boots the next time. But anyway, what I'm getting at, I've been on the road looking for stuff, and I can't find it because winter's coming. It's going to be a long winter. I got 6 months worth of food in that house easily. That her and I would run out of water filtration. Perhaps I need to work on that because now that the rainy season is back, I'm not worried at all about my spring running dry. I would run out of water filtration before we would run out of actual food that I could make in this house between canned things that I personally canned myself this year, canned goods from the store like beans because I've yet to figure out how to can beans. That's a process. I need to learn to grow them first. But, you know, there's certain brands of black beans and pinto beans that we just buy from the store in a can because they're 49 cents. And anyway, I've got a year worth of food in there. Beef jerky, noodles, things that I don't particularly want to live on, but we could get by on a lot of starchy carbohydrates that I have in there. I mean, I've probably got 40 pounds of rice even. I really hope that this isn't affecting you and your region of the world like it's affecting me here, but I think it's going to be nationwide, and I don't know what the answer is, other than this ain't working. And the people in this country, there's some rowdy folks out here where I live. There are some people that are like no joke, fucking America, American people out here. The people around here are only going to take this shit for so long before they start doing something too. This whole half of the state, I ain't never seen more Trump flags and Confederate flags waving freely everywhere in my entire life. Doesn't bother me, whatever. That's your, I'll do me over here, you do you over there, come to my house, we don't talk religion or politics. You know, even though I grew up in California, I do not have a California political mindset whatsoever. And I am eternally grateful that I got away from the educational political indoctrination that is going on in that state. Like, I have family that's gone to college in that state. I got family that's been in college for 25 years in that state. They're almost my age. Well, they are my age, and they're still in college. Anyway, that's beside the point. I don't know, man. It's taken entire days to go and find groceries and come home. And I'm more worried about our survival here as her and I through the winter than I am about uploading things to this YouTube channel, at least currently this week. So I'm going to do what I can to put this video together and put this out there today. And then I've got all kinds of shit that I got to catch up with because I've spent literally half of the week on the road. Well, there's a lull in the rain. I should probably cut the grass. I got laundry to put away. I got laundry to do. I got some floors to clean. I got to finish the same trim boards that I did in my bathroom are going around that closet that I built. I've got them cut. I lack somewhere to stain them when it's raining. So I've been trying to figure out how to move some stuff around inside of the container so that I can put it, because I don't want to drip stain all over this porch that I just had pressure washed and stained myself, and I don't want stain all over this table here either. I have a table that I stain with. We'll say that my plate is stacked to about here currently on shit that I need to get done before this weekend so that we can, again, get in the vehicle and drive down toward the other end of the state, toward Bristol, where it's Bristol, Tennessee and Bristol, Virginia, and see what, if anything, big box stores have down there, because I'm even finding, now that I tried to even order fireplace stuff on the internet and it shows out of stock, and it's on back order, and same thing I ordered another space heater because, well, if I can't get the fireplace in, I need another space heater because it's going to get cold up here real quick, and it's on indefinite back order. Same thing with the boats and the ports. I don't have a whole lot more insightful to say. I've probably said enough to offend half of the people who watch this, and I probably have said enough in the other direction to offend the other half of it, so I've probably offended all of you for having a middle-of-the-road political stance and refusing to particularly take a side there. But, you know, maybe if I made a shirt with a picture of a grilled cheese sandwich on it that said grilled cheese sandwich for president 2024, maybe somebody would buy that. That would actually be kind of funny. That could be a whole channel. I could film grilled cheese sandwiches. Grilled cheese sandwich debate. Somebody else also asked me about, and I'll wrap this up here because there's 13 minutes already, why don't take them into the little stores in town? Show them where I go in town, because all stores in this town are about this big, and there's always like 25 people inside of them, and I'm really not trying to offend anybody locally by filming them. Like, if I ever get a chance to be in one or the other of the only two or three little tiny places that we have, and I'd be the only one in there, I'll absolutely film it, but I'm not trying to walk around and film people from this area. That's why I don't show you any of that stuff. Anyway, that's it for now. Here's to next week being a better week, huh?